today I'm going to be doing my 2011 favorites video, which is really cool because I haven't done a favorites video in like 3 months, I think. And I'm really excited to do this because I picked out some of the products that I've used over and over and over again that I just fell in love with. Because, well, before I say anything else, there's going to be a lot of repeats in here from past favorites videos, but not all of my past items that I've featured are going to be in this video because a lot of them didn't make it to the end of the year. So yeah, but anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this video and leave your favorites down below when you get the chance, or let me know if you and I have the same favorites this year. And yeah, let's just get started. Okay, I'm going to start out with face products because that just seems like a good place to start, so I'm going to start there. I have two foundations. Well, the first one that I've used, I use in the beginning of the year, so like I use it around this time last year, and it's the, don't mind it, it's super dirty. It's the MAC Pro Longer Foundation, and this one is in NC25, and I love it so much. I'm almost out of it actually, but it made it throughout the whole year, which is really cool. I really love this foundation because it's matte, and I don't know, it stays on all day. I just really love the feel of it. Like when I apply it, it feels really, really good. So I really love this foundation. This one made it from MAC, and I've used like 4 of their different foundations and only 2 made it to the end of the year. The second one I barely got, actually, I'm not gonna lie, I got it like a week or two ago, but I fell in love with it. I'm actually wearing it right now, and it's the Matchmaster with SPF 15. It's definitely a taller bottle, so you get more product in there, which is a bonus. But the difference, I guess there's not really, I don't know. I guess one of the big differences is that these come with numbers, like single letter numbers, like this is a 2 and this is NC25. So a 2 would be equivalent to NC25, I think. but anyway, they both leave like a matte finish, and I don't know, I just really like the texture. I don't know how to explain the texture, and I don't want to spend too much time on it because this video is going to be really long. But I really do like these. These are my 2 favorite foundations of 2011. I've used the MAC Pro Longwear for most of the year, and now I'm using my Matchmaster to begin the new year. As far as concealer goes, I only have 1 favorite this year. I've tried different concealers out throughout the year, but this one is my absolute favorite because the only thing I use concealer for really is underneath my eyes to cover up like my dark circles and stuff, which they're not that bad now because I've been taking really good care of my skin, so, and I've been sleeping more, so they're kind of getting better. But anyway, it's the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and this one I got it in a lighter shade. I got it in NW20 because I wanted it to brighten my eyes, and so this one is definitely lighter. I think it's like 2 shades lighter or something like that for my actual skin tone, but I actually have it on right now and hopefully it doesn't look bad. But this is my go-to concealer. The only thing I wish they would change is the packaging because I hate the pump. I wasted so much concealer just trying to get a little itty bit out. So if they change the pump or if they change the packaging on this, I would be super, super happy. But other than that, I really love this concealer. Oh, it's so, so amazing. Well, since we're talking about like foundation and stuff like that, I do, well, you can't see it anymore, but this is the e.l.f. Misten set. Because I know there's higher end ones and stuff like that, but usually for some reason, my makeup stays in place most of the time, so I don't really need to worry about putting a set on my face or anything, or like pressed powder or anything. But the e.l.f. one gets the job done. I just spray it on my face after I complete my makeup, and my makeup's good to go for like the whole day. I literally will have makeup on sometimes from like, say like 10 in the morning to like 10 at night, and my makeup still looks flawless, which is really cool. I don't know if it's because of this or not, but I've been using this a lot, so I'm just gonna add this into my favorites video because I like it. Okay, next things are my favorite. I haven't used these lately because I've been using my NARS blushes, but these are the Milani Baked blushes, and I got these in like November. And so this one is in Rose d'Oro, and I'll show you this one if I could open it. So it just looks like this. It's like a rosy, it's like rose with like gold in it and stuff. It's really, really pretty. I'll try to swatch it for you. It looks like that. So it's like a peachy, really pretty color. I love peachy colors, and this is the first one. So that's Rose d'Oro. I don't know if you can see it. I can't autofocus yet because I don't know how to autofocus. But anyway, next one is in Luminoso. So it looks like this. I'll show you the difference. So this one's a little bit darker, a little bit more, what is it? It's just like a darker pink. And this one has gold in it. And this one is more of like a neutral all around. There's no like, what's it called in there? There's no like different, I don't know how to say. Anyway, they're two different shades. That's all you have to know. Anyway, this one is in Luminoso and it just, it looks like this. It's pretty, it's another like peachy kind of color. I'll use this finger to swatch it for you. So it just looks like that. I don't know if you can see it. It does have a good color pigmentation. It's definitely lighter and it has less of a, well, it's called Luminoso. It like leaves a really luminous finish on there, but this one does too. So I don't know, but this one has like specks of gold in it, so it makes it cooler. But these are my two favorites. And these are actually really good because what I'm about to show you next is kind of pricey. So for those of you who don't want to spend like $30 on a blush, you can get these for $7, and I think that's way better. But the next thing is my NARS palette that I got a couple months ago, and I showed it in a video, and I actually already broke it on the corner, which sucks. I almost cried. No, but I actually really, really love this palette. Sorry if my voice is raspy, it's because I just woke up. So anyway, I'm only gonna show two of my favorites from this palette, but it's actually Orgasm is my favorite right now, and I'm using the Casino bronzer, and I just love both of them. It's my favorite. I'm actually going to buy Orgasm by itself because I really, really like that blush, like a lot. I'm really into beachy blushes, and I think it looks really good on my skin tone, so this was definitely like a good palette to get so that you're able to try out all the different blushes that they have. Well, not all the different blushes, but most of their, you know, like their top blushes, and then pick out the ones you like and then get the actual size. This one, you guys are gonna for those of you who've been watching my favorites videos or just my makeup videos in general, you know I always use this duo, and I feel so bad showing it right now because it's so messed up. But I really loved it. It lasted me the whole year, which is awesome. I think it's time to buy a new one, but I'm trying to get out as much of it that I can. It looks like this. It's the e.l.f. Blush and Bronzing Duo, and it looks like that. I love this so much. Like, you have no idea. It has the bronzing powder, which is right here, which I used to contour. And I actually used it today to contour. And I love this one. And then this one is supposed to be like a dupe for, well, it's supposed to be a dupe for Orgasm and Laguna from NARS. I don't know if it's a dupe for Laguna, but for Orgasm, definitely not. It's definitely way more sheer. It kind of reminds me of Luminoso a little bit from the Milani. Whatchamacallit, the Milani blushes, except the Milani blushes are way more pigmented. This has like a nice, this would be good for like a highlight because it has a lot of shimmer in it and stuff, but I definitely don't think it's a dupe for Orgasm at all because I'm wearing Orgasm right now and this does not look like this. So that's another thing, but I definitely love the contouring bronzing powder. I use it almost every day, obviously, as you can see. It lasted me a whole year, which is really awesome. And I love this because it's only $3. So if you don't want to buy the Orgasm Laguna Duo, definitely get this. I've said good things about this so many times before. The blush, not so much, but the bronzer is really, really good if you want a really pigmented bronzer. So, whoa, okay, so my camera died. Sorry about that. The next one is the Facial Clay Mask with Avocado and Oatmeal, which I've been using all year too, and I actually still have a lot because I don't use it much, but when I do, I really love how it feels on my skin. I showed this in a how to de-stress your skin video a long time ago, which don't look for it because it's an old video and I hate my old videos because they're just so bad. But anyway, but I think that's how we all feel when we see our older videos. We're just like, what were we thinking? Like, that's so bad. But anyway, so it's this and I really, really love it. It smells really good and it dries like really hard on your skin. It's not a peel off, which I kind of don't like. I'm going to try like one of the peeling ones that you just like peel right off. But this way you just wash it off and your skin feels really refreshed and like squeaky clean. Like, it cleans out your pores really well. So I really like this, and I got this at Walmart for like $4. So it's really good. You should try it out if you're looking for something like this. Oh, now I don't even use body lotion anymore because, as you guys know, I always say I have like normal to dry skin, but mainly dry skin, and it's really hard for me to find a good lotion that actually lasts and moisturizes my skin for like a whole 24 hours. But I actually just like found out about the Johnson's Baby Creamy Oil. It's not a baby lotion, it's baby oil, but in a cream form, which is really good if you don't like how baby oil feels on your skin. It feels really like slippery and shiny. If you don't like that, this leaves like a matte finish on your skin and it really seeps in there and it's not greasy, which is really good. I've been using this one. I'm on my second bottle. This is the cocoa and shea butter and it smells just like chocolate, which is really nice. So if you like chocolatey smells, then get this one. This one smells really good. And I also use, I'm running out of the aloe vera and a vitamin E one, which is also really good. This one smells like cucumber. And they're like really, really good. And they'll last you a really long time. I was kind of disappointed because they only have these small bottles. Well, they're not small, but I mean, they're not a huge lotion bottle that you would get for $5. It's like $4 for one of these. And it actually lasts a really long time. There's 8 ounces in here, so. And a little goes a long way. Like I said, they smell really good and they really do feel really, really good on your skin. And you can find these in like the baby section at Target or something like that, but they're really, really good. Next thing is the Jergens Natural Glow Moisturizer, which looks like this. And this one's to fair to medium skin tone. I did a video on the self tanner a long time ago, like in the spring. And I really, really like this one because it really works, except all self tanners have that after smell. So it does have that after smell, which is one thing I don't like. But I do like that it gives you like a subtle glow so you can keep building it until you get super dark the way you want. But other than that, this is my favorite self tanner of the year. On to hair care. I only have 2 items that I think are my favorite of the whole year, which is crazy. I had to narrow it down to just 2 because there's a lot and this video is going to be really long. But it's the Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine Anti-Frizz Serum. It looks like this. And I mentioned it in my hair video. And I really like it because it really does leave your hair really soft and frizz free, which is what I like because I have a lot of hair and it's really thick, so it's like I need to tame it down sometimes, and this really helps with it and it helps keep it healthy too. Next one is my Suave Kids Detangler, which I talked about in my last hair video, and I really love it because it takes out all my tangles. I'm one of those people that when you wash your hair and you get out of the shower, you have like a bunch of knots in your hair. I don't know, I have a bunch of knots in my hair sometimes because I have so many layers that they get tangled together. But this really helps release those, and it smells really good. This one's my favorite because it smells like strawberries. And it's like $2 and it works really well even though it's for kids. So this is one of my favorite hair products of the year. Next are nail polishes. I've been crazy for glitter polishes all year, and I have 3 of my favorites. First one, as you guys know, is this one from CoverGirl, which is in Disco Dazzle that I've used most of the year. So this is just like a glitter, silver glitter, like big chunky glitter nail polish that I use as a top coat on solid colors. This one is the Milani Jewel Fix, which has a lot of chunky glitters, more than the CoverGirl. They kind of look different, if you can see. I'm not a big fan of this one because it's really, really hard to take off, but it's really, really pretty, and it looks like your nails are jeweled, which is really awesome. Next one is my favorite Sally Hansen Extreme Wear in Strobe Light, and it just looks like this, and it's like pink glitters and stuff. It's really pretty. And that's my last favorite one. So those are all my favorite glitter nail polishes. Other than that, I think these are all my yearly favorites. I might make a part 2 to this because I might have more items that I've used. I'm pretty sure there's more things that I favorited throughout the year, but these are my main favorites that I've used almost every single day and stuff like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any favorites, leave them down below so I know about them. And don't forget to comment and like this video if you like it. And I'll be making new videos again next week, hopefully on a constant basis, now that I have a new camera that hopefully you guys are okay with. Other than that, I'll talk to you guys again real soon. Bye.